Welcome back, guys, to another video. Let's talk about my moves for next week because it's going to be a pretty big week. 5 trading days. It's going to be post-election. We should be hearing some news about who's going to be president. Most likely Joe Biden, and for some reason, during election week, it soared. Stocks went up insane. I actually played elections, and I really enjoyed it, and I actually got some pretty decent attendees to definitely show off. Made roughly about $3,500 from election week, and that was pretty awesome. And currently, my positions are going to be pretty boring for TD Ameritrade, but for Robinhood, it will be pretty interesting since I did do a pretty decent recovery from the very bottom, which I was down about 54%, and now I'm all the way up. And I'm also pretty deep into NIO. My Robinhood account, of course, is a YOLO account, is an account to have some fun. I'm going all in, chips on the table for a NIO stock. So let's go through some of the stuff. Currently, my account size, I started off at around $70,000. It's kind of hard to grow it, especially with the market volatility going up and down, not losing any money, in my opinion, is good enough. And I currently have roughly 208 shares of SPY. And the reason why I have all these shares is to simply sell cover calls. I currently have 2 cover calls for the $352 strike price. Now, currently $352 is a dollar away from the current strike price, which is $350.96. So if they do surpass 352 on Monday, which is when it expires, so it's literally what, the first trading day of the week, I could get roughly like $500-$600-ish, and that is a really big boost to my portfolio. Now, obviously, though, you may think trading with a 5-digit account, making a few hundred dollars isn't impressive, but keep in mind, this is super passive income. I'm simply wheeling 2 SPY contracts. I'm gonna keep wheeling until my shares get recalled, and then I'll start selling cash secured puts. I'll keep doing it until I'm forced to buy shares. This is a really smart strategy. This is how people grow. And since the S&P 500 has huge periods when it's completely flat, it's the perfect stock to do it. Currently, S&P 500, it has rallied up. And in the past few days, it's been pretty flat. November 5th, it's pretty flat. November 6th, it's pretty flat. In a flat market, I don't really mind it, honestly. And the cool thing about SPY is 3 expiration dates per week, 3 paychecks per week, I could roughly bring in $300 worth of premiums every single 2 days. So there's 3 expiration dates, 3 times 300, I should get roughly $900 in premiums every single week. There's 4 weeks in a month, 4 times 900 is $3,600. I could make about roughly $3,600 to $4,000 from just simply selling SPY contracts. I could sell 2 of them. This is a really good consistent income strategy. $3,000 to $4,000 a month, that is some really good cash. That's like going out and actually working like 8 to 10 hours a day for like 6 days a week. It's really, really good. Like seriously, if you guys don't believe me, I will be wheeling SPY for the next few months, giving you guys the results every single week. But currently it's doing pretty well because the markets rallied so hard on election week. I'm actually up a decent amount, so that's actually pretty good. But I would not be making $3,000 a week anymore. Since SPY is more stable, I'm most likely to be making roughly $900 to $1,000 a week, which isn't that impressive in the grand scheme of things, but this is so stable to the point that it's like literally consistent income. It's like owning a house. I currently own 200 shares of SPY. It's like owning a $76,000 home that generates like $3,000, $4,000 per month. It like generates profits insane. It's pretty nice. And people say like, okay, holding a bunch of shares isn't safe. This is an S&P 500 ETF we're talking about. This isn't like Genius Brands. This isn't like me buying a bunch of shares at ExxonMobil. This is SPY, which is like hosting some of the biggest companies on earth. And these companies are stable. And some of these companies are mostly cloud companies, software companies, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon are all in SPY. I mean, some even say that's safer than a house, because these companies will never go away and only expand bigger and bigger. On top of that, I'll also even get getting some sweet, sweet dividends every single once in a while, and that is pretty nice as well. Now, let's talk about the Robinhood portfolio. A lot of you guys have been talking about, okay, man, you gotta show off the Robinhood portfolio. So I start off with $1,000. I added in $500 more, because I feel like I just didn't have enough money to do anything at that point. Because like $1,000 dropping like 54-55%, you only have about $400-$500 left. At one point I was down like 200. It was pretty bad. I was down like 70-80%, but I finally did bounce back. At one point I did hit $2,000, which was a $500 profit from this small Robinhood account. And currently the positions that really saved me were NIO calls. And currently NIO calls right now, they're doing pretty great, not gonna lie. And so far they are pretty much going to the absolute moon. And so far with these NIO calls, I'm down 12%, down roughly $200. My whole entire Robinhood portfolio is all in on NIO calls. I have six of them. Hopefully on Monday it's super green, so I could somewhat sell half of it for profit and hold the other half. I've been playing a lot more conservatively with my options now, because it's always nice to take in some profits. If you see like 20, 30, 50% gains, sell half your contracts and hold the other half. Like seriously, like lock in some of your profits. But so far in the past week, I nearly doubled my portfolio with NIO calls. In the past month, you can clearly see still playing some catch up, but at one point I was super green. And in the very bottom, I was down like roughly 55%. It was pretty bad, but now I finally bounced back and it feels really, really good. Currently, all the chips on NIO. Hopefully it goes up. I picked the $47 strike price, which is pretty insane, but I did drag my expiration down a full 2 weeks. Even the stock does drop, I'll only be getting a major hit like 20-30%. Nothing too crazy. So overall, I feel like NIO definitely keep going up. It's a pretty decent stock with a lot of momentum. Friday was a day when it's completely flat, and who knows, maybe next trading day we could be seeing a major boost in NIO, especially with so many big banks and hedge funds jumping on the train. People want to have NIO. It has so much momentum that even right now a lot of people are kind of skeptical about going in, but I feel like it's definitely great to do some swing trades, and I wouldn't really mind if NIO stays flat for the next couple of trading days, just simply to consider, you know, consolidate, make sure everything's okay, because you don't want the stock to keep going up with no breaks, because that equals to a massive drop. So a couple of days of consolidation without much movement is necessary for the stock to keep going up. And so far the main portfolio, I'm just wheeling. This is like my passive income thing. I'm just going for 70K in the account. Let's see if I could make out probably a few more $1,000 by the end of this month. That would be pretty cool. If I could somehow hit like 90K on this account, that would be pretty awesome as well. And you guys always ask me, why do you wheel when you can simply hold shares? Well, there's several times in the year where the stock market is completely flat. Your shares will not lose money. Your shares will not make money, but your premiums would. And if you look at SPY premiums right now, they're honestly pretty nice. And they're not that bad at all. Like, I'll sell this one, continue. I'll sell like two of these and make like $590. Like, it's pretty nice. And sell some covered calls if I get shares. And I'll buy stock before the ex-dividend date and get some dividends. And I'll sell covered calls. And on the dividend date, the stock does drop a little bit, so I make money from dividends and the covered calls. So it's actually a pretty smart method. And honestly though, this is pretty nice. This is going to be a super long-term account. I'm not going to just buy stock because that's super slow. I'm going to buy stock and sell options at the same time, make money from the dividends, the premiums, and also the stock price itself. Thanks for watching, guys, and comment below.